Hey there, Service Pros. This is Christian from the Workiz product team. In this video, we're going to talk about working with subcontractors and Workiz. In Workiz, you can create a team made up of users and subcontractors. Depending on your plan, you'll have a certain number of paid users you can invite to your account. Those users can be assigned various roles with various permissions for your account, like viewing job details and collecting online and offline payments. These are typically reserved for people who are employees of your business. But as a service business, there's a decent chance you sometimes do business with people who aren't employees. In Workiz, we call them subcontractors. You can add as many of them as you'd like, but they're also fairly limited in what they can do. Subcontractors can only be assigned to jobs, close them out, collect offline payments, and receive messages. They won't receive a login to access your Workiz account. Let's take a deeper dive into working with subcontractors in Workiz. In order to add a subcontractor to your team, you'll first need to enable the add-on from the marketplace. That's this icon up here. We'll scroll down to add-ons and select subcontractors. We'll turn this toggle switch on to activate the add-on. After doing that, we'll be able to add subcontractors to our team. You can do that by adding a new team member from the team page or by selecting the Create button up here. You'll have the option to choose between a paid user and a free subcontractor. Obviously, for this video, we'll go with subcontractor. You'll notice a handful of fields disappear when doing so. You won't be able to assign this user to a role, label them as a field tech right away, or track their location. The only fields you will have to fill out are email address, name, schedule color, and phone number. We'll hit Add User and then head over to the profile page to update a few things. First, we need to select this field for field tech and choose Yes so Workiz allows us to assign jobs to the subcontractor. Next, we'll select the service areas this person operates in and the skills this person has. This way, when assigning jobs, Workiz can automatically filter out the members of your team who can actually perform the job based on the service address and skills required. Let's say this is a subcontractor we work with because he's the only person we know who can work jobs in a certain area. We'll go ahead and assign that area here. He can do it all, so we'll leave the skill section blank. Now let's show you what it's going to look like when you assign a job to a subcontractor. We'll enter an address in the service area that this subcontractor works in, and Workiz will automatically tell us that there's only one person on our team who can be assigned to this job. It's the subcontractor we just added. What comes next after booking the job will depend on how your account is set up. We'll want to notify our subcontractor of the job we just created and assigned. To do that, we can either manually send a message from the job page using this button right here, or automatically send one using Workiz automations. With Workiz automations, you can create a rule that automatically sends a text message to your subcontractors whenever you assign them to a new job. You can include information like the job date, service address, job type, details, and a confirmation link. To learn more about how to create automation rules, feel free to check out the link in the description below. But let's say you want to keep it basic and do it the old-fashioned way. You can easily edit the template message that is manually sent from the job page by heading over to the text message settings page. Under Job Text Message Template, you'll see a text box where you can customize the message. And if you include a confirmation link in this message, you can turn this toggle switch on to enable job closing. This will allow your subcontractor to close jobs from a web page on their mobile device. They'll be able to collect offline payments and close the job so that the status changes to done pending approval. And that's it. That's all you need to know to get started with subcontractors. Feel free to subscribe to this channel for all the latest on how Workiz can help your business grow. And as always, if you have any questions, we're here to help. Thanks for watching.